Hello, everyone, and welcome back to Pokemon Go. We are getting ready for a very early morning walk to go see what we can find out in the world because I have been completely shamed by my siblings. So we're over here with our Pokemon, and I'm just kind of having a great time wandering around, looking at the squirrels in the trees, and having a good time finding cool flowers to show to you guys. And I'm like, oh, cool, we're gathering up some Pokemon. Everything's good in the world. And then my siblings start sending me some of their messages every day, and my family's totally into Pokemon. So all of my siblings are currently off searching for Pokemon. They have their kids searching for Pokemon with them. And I'm like, oh, cool. What's your strongest Pokemon? And they're like, oh, not much. Just my like CP 700 Venusaur. And I'm sitting over here with Pearl. Poor little Pearl, who is my strongest Pokemon. And she's just kind of kicking it up. Like, yep, 142 CP, that's as strong as she is. So I have been completely shamed, you guys. I believe that we need to head out and we need to go find many, many more Dratini and kind of build up our team. I actually am willing to find even more Pidgey, so I kind of need your opinion. We have this Pidgey, which I actually caught on a walk yesterday with my boyfriend, and it's at 101 CP. I need to name it. I'm kind of tempted to name it Flight after our Pidgey that we had in our Pixelmon Ranger series, which, by the way, if you're watching this, I will give you a hint that Pixelmon Ranger, the Minecraft Pokemon series, will be returning very soon, especially now that it has some updated mods. So I'm super, super excited, super looking forward to that. But we could evolve this little one, and I need your guys' opinion. Should we evolve it? It knows Quick Attack and Air Cutter right now. Is it really going to learn anything new if we evolve it, or is it just going to like use up Pidgey candy for the sake of Pokedex completion? So I need to decide on that. But we have been saving up our Stardust and saving up our Pidgey candy so that we can either evolve or power up some of our Pidgey. I've also released all of the duplicate Rattata, so we have an extremely tiny Rattata left. So this is our strongest Rattata, CP89. I don't really have a name for him yet. He was just caught around the lake as usual, and so around Dratini Lake as usual. I like to imagine he's the one that was trying to escape the Ekans, but I don't think our Ekans would have bothered with such a tiny, tiny, tiny Rattata. Should we evolve him? Should we power him up? Should we do either or? He knows Body Slam and Quick Attack right now, so you know what? I think we should evolve him. So we're gonna have like the smallest Raticate ever. We're gonna evolve him. Let's do it, you guys. Yeah. Hey, I said, oh, is it trying to figure it out? I think it's trying to figure out. Dang it! There we go. Okay, thank goodness. I thought it crashed, and I was like, no, what's gonna happen to my tiny Rattata? Here he goes, you guys. Look at him go. Dun 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 dun. And now we have like the tiniest little Raticate ever. He's so small. He's so small and cute. That's okay. A lot of my friends actually have rats that are pretty awesome. All right, so there we go, our Raticate, and he's still tiny. And now we can power him up at least. If whoa, CP 228. Okay, yeah, we're gonna choose to evolve that Pidgey. I didn't realize it would give such a huge rank up in CP. All right, we'll do that. And now he knows Hyper Beam too. Okay, so Pidgey, we're gonna evolve you too. And let's go ahead and do this. So we're starting off the morning strong with so many evolutions. I didn't realize that it raised their CP rate so high, or else I totally would have done it earlier. All right. There we go, Pidgeotto. How are you doing, buddy? We're gonna need the help to take down the gyms because blue team is not winning at the gyms around here. Also, apologies if you hear my real life birds. Just think of them as real life Pidgeys in the background. Why do you weigh nothing? That's not normal. That's not normal. That can't be normal. Is my Pidgeotto about to die? It doesn't weigh anything. Where's some bird seed? I'm gonna steal some bird seed from my finches and like feed it to this Pidgeotto. Are you okay, buddy? Still wing an air cutter. Well, we're about to be able to evolve him up again. So today we will be looking for some Pidgey as well as our usual Dratini. And I really have a passion for Oddish and grass types, so I would love to find more of them. But all right, and then nothing else too new. We still have the pincer that we caught. He was actually checking out the cherry blossoms at the Pokestop when somebody activated the module. So I feel like he's a flower-loving pincer who everybody runs away from, but he just really wants to be a little gardener because I love coming up with stories like that. Thornberry is doing good. I guess we'll evolve Thornberry pretty soon, but I'm gonna wait until I can evolve him past being a Kakuna. So we're gonna hold on to it. He's a nice fat little guy eating off my tomatoes that I keep on the deck. And then I think that covers everyone for now. I'm keeping a lot of the Dratini we catch lately, but I really should start releasing them. I'm going to start releasing the Dratini unless they're over CP 100, because then it will allow them to, except for Shoelace. Shoelace is weak and tiny, I know, but Shoelace is my itty bitty little very first catch Dratini. And he was my very first, or she, it was my very first wild catch. So I can't get rid of Shoelace. It has to stay here forever. All right, but yeah, all right, Raticate. So you're gonna need a new name, my tiny, tiny little Raticate. And I do have some duplicates, so I'm gonna have to figure out what to do with. Oh, and Arnost is the new name of my Ekans. So Arnost the Ekans. We'll have to see if we will get him taken care of as well. And then finally, I do have some new eggs that I got from the Pokestops. We have a 5 kilometer egg and we have a 10 kilometer egg. And I'm really excited to see what the 10 one hatches into, because I hear sometimes you can get rare Pokemon from that. So we're gonna head out. We're gonna start on our little morning walk. And then one really, really, whoa, am I gonna level up? Sweet, sweet. All right, incense. I'm definitely gonna use an incense. Yes, we're gonna turn an incense on. Evolve 3 Pokemon, sweet, got a medal. And I'll turn an incense on, but I did learn something new I wanted to share with you guys. So thank you guys so much for the advice and comments on telling me how you can figure out what direction you're supposed to walk in. I can't believe I didn't know this until now. But basically, you select the Pokemon you want, and you hit the compass. And then see how it changed direction. Normally, it'll face north all the time. But if you have the Pokemon you want selected and hit the compass, boom. It'll lock you in the direction you're supposed to go to find that Pokemon. And then you guys know how the steps mean you're closer or further away from that Pokemon. So this changed my life. I now know what direction to go when we're trying to find all of these little guys. Like if we wanted this Pidgey, where am I gonna go for this Pidgey? Tell me, Compass. Compass says across the lake. Thanks, Compass. I can't swim that fast. Oh my gosh. All right, so we're gonna head out. Oh, that's a Vaporeon who has taken over the gym. Taken over Water Snake Creek Gym. Phooey. And then actually somebody has a Lapras. I'm so envious. Look at that Lapras behind us. But we're going to head out and we're going to see what we can find both in real animals and in Pokemon on our little walk today. And also see if we can hatch those eggs. So let's get going. I hardly had a chance to leave the house. And all right, Pidgey. And I'm actually really curious because I can hear all sorts of real birds. I'm going to see if I can come around and see who's making all that noise. Good job, Pidgey. All right, good, good, good. Let's go see what that real bird is that's making all that noise. Who knows, but you sound really, really pretty. I wonder what it would be like if animals actually said their name. Maybe there would be more people interested in botany. That's who it is! Hi, baby! Oh, this is one of my favorite birds, you guys. This right here is a Carolina wren, and they are one of my absolute favorite birds. They're very inquisitive. Wrens are definitely one of my favorite species. But it's so, so teeny tiny, and it has the loudest little voice, even though it's so small. I love these guys. All right, no. Oh my gosh. Don't dodge, little one. I'm next to a busy road. I don't have time for this. There we go. The lake looks beautiful this morning. And there's so many birds making so much noise in the trees. It's kind of fitting that so far I'm only finding Pidgey. Oh, and I did find a Magikarp a second ago. All right, a really fat Pidgey. All right, let's see if we can find any more Pokemon. There have to be more than just this nearby. Huh. Alright you guys, well some exciting news as we stop by this Pokestop really quickly and collect what we can. Apparently there's a Scyther nearby and I just passed up a fellow trainer, I guess, who was also looking for him and had headed off. So we might be going into the faraway neighborhoods pretty soon and trying something new. So this could be kind of exciting. We're gonna see if we can track him down. As you can see, the compass keeps moving and that's because we're locked onto him. And so it'll kind of move wherever he's going. And it looks like the neighborhood's next to us. So, you know, I haven't ventured over there just yet. So we'll try that out. That could be really fun, actually. So let's go see if we can find him. If there wasn't a forest in my way, I would just like go left immediately, but I can't. So this is going to be cool. I like this. Walking in totally new areas that I'm going to have to come up with names for. No way, just as I was getting ready to show you guys a bunch of turtles.
Eevee, get in there.
All right, not bad. We're back at Turtle Court, and I'm trying to decide. The problem is I live next to some really busy roads, so I'm trying to decide. I don't think it's worth it for even a Scyther to try to cross the street right now, so we're not gonna, but we'll see. Where are you locked on at now, sir? Seriously? You're really gonna do that to me? Darn, you guys, we're gonna lose them. There's just no safe way to get across that road, so phooey. Man, so close too. What? He changed directions? Really? I'm not gonna complain if I don't have to go across the big scary highway. Alright. Continuing on then. Also, I really love the idea of getting a Vaporeon, but that's gonna help because we just got an Eevee. And I wish we could run across some Dratini. I have no idea why nothing is showing up. Phooey. Alright. Well, let's see what we've got here. And maybe we can at least... Oh, another egg! And maybe we can at least hatch our eggs today. And we'll have to see if the theory, there we go, of following where the compass tells you to go when you're trying to find these guys actually works or not. Because if it's telling me to go off the highway, then we're out of luck, you guys. That's not something that can happen. Oh my gosh. 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 Wild river otters. Wild river otters. There's wild otters here. Oh my goodness. That's a family of otters. I need to go capture those for a specimen spotlight, like, right now. You guys, look. There they are. That is a family of otters. That is a family, a wild family of otters. Oh my gosh. So I'm a sweaty mess because that's what this is all about, going out on my daily walks with a little bit of extra pizzazz and fun. And I will talk about why Pokemon Go is so important to my family in another day. But you guys, wild otters. Scyther is going to now forever be. I don't know if I'm ever going to catch him, but he is going to be super special to me because I'm going to remember the time when I was like, let's try to catch a Scyther, and ended up seeing a little family of wild river otters right before we're getting ready to move out of North Carolina. I have lived here for a year. I'm like standing here hoping they'll come back. I have lived here for an entire year. And I have been lucky enough to see a beaver, which nobody who, like, I'm friends with who lives here has ever seen a beaver at this lake. And now I have just seen wild river otters because I just happened to go, let's go see if I can hatch some eggs, maybe find some more Pidgey. And to me, that's what Pokemon Go is all about, you guys. People keep leaving comments like, no, Siri, don't do Pokemon Go. You're gonna get stabbed. It's gonna be an armed robbery. Like, you're gonna stumble on things. And the thing is, I've done these vlogs, these walking vlogs, and I'm so excited about the river otters, so bear with me while I just talk for a second. But I've done these walking vlogs for like years now. I love coming outside and showing you guys what I see. I am trained in biology. I get to point at things and go, hey, do you know that's a such and such a cowbird? It parasites nests, which means that it leaves its eggs in other birds' nests for them to raise. I can teach you guys about what's out here while I'm adventuring and exploring and just embracing the natural world. And to me, that's what Pokemon Go is all about. It's about new opportunities. I have talked with people, like, while I'm on my Pokemon Go walks, who are very clearly very shy introverts who are coming out of their shell because they have Pokemon to talk about with me. And I'm so happy about that. I'm so happy about that. I'm so happy that when the guy asked me if I was looking for Scyther, I said, no, but I'm looking at this blue heron feather. And he was like, oh, cool. You know, I got to teach him that there were blue herons at the lake. You know, just those kinds of things. He probably knew already, but you know what I mean? Otters. And to create new memories. You never know where you're gonna head off. You never know what you're gonna stumble on while you're looking for these Pokemon. And I think that everybody's focusing on like the negatives, like an armed robbery, a dead body, while finding Pokemon Go stuff. But you guys, it's also baby ducklings and wild river otters. and just beautiful flowers in unexpected places, literally in my own backyard that I have never walked before because I never had the need or urge to. And now I'm going because I want to go visit a new Pokestop or see what Eevee, like how close I can get to an Eevee and if I can catch it. And that's awesome. So, okay, I'll stop talking now, but I'm just so excited and I just wanted to kind of clarify that with you guys, is that it's not just about catching the Pokemon, it's about looking up every now and then and trying to see what new things you see in the world. And it's also about creating positive memory associations, because like I said, Scyther, forever going to be one of my favorite Pokemon now because wild otters. I can't find any Pokemon today and it's kind of frustrating and everybody's going to be like, Seri, you didn't do any Pokemon, I'm so mad at you, you just talked, get your big face out of the way. But wild river otters! That's awesome! And I'll see if we can find any more Pokemon. My incense actually already got used up and I still, they're just not loading in right now. We'll go see if we can find that Scyther. That would be like, I would name him Otter. That would be the name of him. Wow, that's so cool. Yes! Oh, wild river otters! You have delivered to me! We have another little Weedle. So let's catch him. He is a tiny Weedle too. He's only got a CP of 17. And then a Bellsprout! My very first Bellsprout! Maybe I'll name the Bellsprout Otter. Like Otter Flower or something ridiculous like that to celebrate the fact that, hello, there were wild river otters! Come back here, Bellsprout! Bellsprout, there you are. Here, let's try to get a better picture with you. Or, okay, never mind. You want to dance on my shadow. That's fine. That's fine. Your shadow, you're latching into my shadow. Maybe we're bonding. All right, in you go. My first Bellsprout. It is going to be named like Otterflower for sure. Otterpaw, I have no idea. Otters. Oh, I'm so excited. I'm just as excited as when I found the beaver. Even more so maybe because that was a whole little family of otters. Oh my gosh. All right, and Bellsprout. I'm so happy that's my first Bellsprout. Wonderful. And all right, 10 bug type Pokemon. Oh, and 10 poison type Pokemon, sweet. And still nobody nearby. And the Scyther is indeed gone. And I'm a little sad about that, but you guys, come on, otters. All right, let's go collect stuff from the Pokestops and see how our eggs are doing really quickly. It just doesn't look like today is a good Pokemon hunting day. Oh, no way, did I get another 10 kilometer egg? Come here, come here. All right, I did. All right, 2 rare eggs and 3 uncommon eggs. We're gonna hatch these guys. All right, let's get moving. I don't believe it, this Rattata has escaped like twice. Get in the Pokeball. Ah, I keep hoping those river otters will show back up. I'm standing here at Water Snake Creek. Like any second you guys can show up. I see fish moving under the water. Come on, otters, but they're gone. That was amazing. I am so happy. And there's like literally no Pokemon near me. What is this nonsense? All right.
An Oddish? Where is it? Really?
Why does it have to be across the scary highway? That's not cool. Come on, Oddish. Why are you being like that? You know what we need to do, you guys? I think today hasn't been the most successful venture other than wild river otters. And I need to fix that. Do I see wild river otters? No, those are just a rock. I'm like frantically scanning the terrain, hoping I'll see them again, even though I know they're gone. But what we'll do is next time, oh my gosh, are those ducklings? No, that's also a rock. I'm just too excited. Oh, aha, wake up. There we go. All right. Anyway, sorry about that. I'm so excited about river otters that I can't focus on anything. So I think we're going to call it for now because I can't go on the highway to get that Oddish. And what we're going to do, well, Rattata, where are you? What we're going to do is next time I'm going to go into a neighborhood and walk around in there, like the far, far away neighborhoods, and walk around in there and see what we catch. All right, so back at home base, and I have to admit, you guys, we didn't catch very much. Like, we didn't catch very much at all. And that short little morning walk didn't really produce as much as I was hoping, but I'm learning a couple important things. Pokemon, I've been told, don't show up too much right up against the water, and they tend to be right off of actual roads. And my big problem is I live next to a couple big highways, and so I need to get away from here. So what I think I'm gonna do next time is go into the far, far away neighborhood where I have never really ventured before, other than when I was chasing a red-tailed hawk and wanted to follow the hawk and the fledgling that was with it. So we're going to go into the far away neighborhood sometime in the future, because being in more closely packed in streets is probably going to really help us when it comes to catching Pokemon, because it doesn't seem like Pokemon Go really understands that, hey, I can't even go over into any of those spots because they're across major highways. And a lot of people have said, Siri, you're leveling so slow. Why don't you get in your car and drive around? Well, I donated my car a few months ago, you guys, so I don't even have a car because I gave it away since I used it so little. And I'm able to get around pretty much everywhere I want to go, like the Wild River Otter Creek, oh my gosh, anytime I really need to. And I have, you know, my wonderful boyfriend who lets me use his car when need be, but I actually prefer walking around and exploring places on foot. So we'll go into the far away neighborhood and try to work our way into more tightly packed areas so that we can get more Pokemon in the future. And I also want to find more Dratini. The Dratini are really eluding me, and I want to become a Dratini trainer before we leave North Carolina, because I've been told there are not a lot of Dratini, there's just mostly Tangela near where we're moving. So I want to catch lots and lots of Dratini and like have a Dragonite, and I want to have all of my Dratini really high level. It should be awesome. So we'll do that in the future, and I apologize there weren't very many Pokemon today, but there were Wild River Otters! So I'm still super excited about that. Alright, and then I have named the Bellsprout. It is now named Otterleaf, and it is going to remain Otterleaf until maybe it'll grow into Otter Blossom as it evolves, but it's just a tiny little thing. It's so adorable. It has almost no critical points, and I love it because grass types are one of my absolute favorites. I have to admit that Dragonair and Dragonite is... siblings. Dragonair and Dragonite is very, very quickly becoming one of my favorites as well, because I love them so much. I also gave away all of the other the Rattata, so that we can level up our Raticate, because right now he's actually one of my best fighters. So we have a lot that we can level him up as so that we could take on some fights. And then I also gave away almost all of the Pidgey so that we can evolve our Pidgeotto. So let's go ahead and evolve our Pidgeotto. This should be pretty awesome. There you go, Pidgey. It's a busy day for you at least, because you get to evolve twice. Look at those beautiful tail feathers! It's like the red-tailed hawk, the red-tailed hawks that are in the area. That is so cool. Alright, dun-dun-dun! Alright, look at you now, Pidgeot. You don't look that different from here. Alright, there we go! Fully evolved our Pidgey. That makes me very happy. And now we have a Pidgeot, and we still have 4 Pidgey candies left, so I can go ahead and just feed this guy. And my sister was just showing off pictures of her like 2000 CP freaking level executor. So I've got a long way to go to catch up with my siblings, but I am going to be doing my best. Hey, I wasn't done with you, Pidgeot. I wasn't done with you. So Pidgeot is now our top fighter. And I'm just going to keep leveling it up for a minute. So Pidgeot's definitely now our top fighter. And yet it's still probably not strong enough to take on the gyms. I know a lot of you guys want me to go in battle, and the sad truth of the matter is I don't think we have enough oomph to even be able to try to take on this gym. Well, that is a water type, isn't it? Huh. Well, you know, we'll check it out in the future, but right now, I have a lot more Pokemon catching, Pokemon evolving, Pokemon raising to do, and hopefully something really cool will hatch out of our eggs in the future. Also, are you guys noticing this? Like, our eggs are not moving at the same rate, so we'll keep an eye on that too. Anyway, that was really exciting. I am so excited to have Otterleaf, and like I said, Scyther's forever going to be super special to me because I stumbled on the beautiful river otters while looking for a Scyther. So what a day! And I can't wait to see what we get up to next time. So I will see you guys then when we will go on more adventures, hopefully to the far away neighborhoods. And we'll see if being around streets that are a lot more tightly packed together, even if they're far away from Pokestops, will actually help us catch more Pokemon. So I'll see you guys then. Bye-bye!